In this video, I'm gonna show you the easiest way to set up YouTube subscribers count widget with iOS 14. And hey, if you're new here, my name is Shaq and this channel is all about tech content. Last month, I made a video showing you guys how I made my own YouTube subscribers count widget using a third-party application known as Widgerido. That app allows us to create customized widgets, and since we didn't have any official application that actually allowed us to have the YouTube subscribers count widget, I made a tutorial showing you guys how you guys can actually create your own subscriber count widget from scratch. But I've got good news. We finally have an official application and I'll be talking about it in this video. At the end of the video, I'll also talk about the pros and the cons of both of the methods. I'll talk about the very first method where you create your own widget from scratch versus the actual method, which is the official application. I've been using both of the methods for a considerable period of time and I found relevant to show you guys the pros and the cons, and I'll also let you guys know which method I actually prefer and which method I use every day. Okay, so here we are on my phone, and as you guys can see, I already have the subscribers widget right here. But what I'm gonna do is I'll just delete this widget and I'm gonna set everything up from scratch with you guys. So the first thing you need to do is go straight to the App Store, obviously, to download the application. You're gonna search for sub widget, okay? You're gonna search for this application and you're gonna see an application that looks like this. You're gonna open, okay, you'll download it first, obviously, and you won't be having any channel over here. In order for you to get your channel, the first thing you need to do is just go to YouTube, okay? Go straight to YouTube. And you're going to open your YouTube channel's profile. You're gonna click on these three dots over here and you're going to click on share, okay? So you wanna get the YouTube's link, and then you're gonna go back to the sub widget application. You'll just paste the link over here. You're gonna click on submit and the app is gonna tell it that the app couldn't actually find your channel's ID. So you're gonna click on find my ID real quick, and a website like this is going to open. Once the website opens, you're gonna scroll down and you'll see this bar right here. You just need to paste the YouTube channel's link that you've copied previously. You're gonna click on get YouTube channel ID. So here we go. We've got the YouTube channel ID right here. All you need to do is just select. Let me just see if I can focus. Okay, cool. So all we need to do is just select the YouTube channel's ID. Okay, so I'm gonna select it up to the end. This is my channel's ID. Now, this is a bit tricky because the cursor as well as the background have the same color. It's the blue color. So you need to be a bit careful over here while selecting the entire YouTube channel. You're gonna click on copy to copy the YouTube details. And then you'll open the sub widget app once again. Over here, you're just gonna paste your YouTube channel's ID and click on submit. That's all. And as you guys can see right now, I've got my YouTube subscriber widget right here. I've got the medium as well as the small size widget. The next thing you need to do is just go straight to your home screen. You're gonna go into the jiggle mode by pressing on any application. You're gonna click on the plus sign right here and you're going to select sub widget. Okay, this is the application that you've got right here. And here we go, you're going to select whether you want the medium size widget or the small. I'll select the medium size. Boom, here we go, we've got the YouTube subscribers count widget right here. Now, let's talk about the pros and the cons of both of the methods. The very first method, which is the Widgerido, the one where you create your own thing from scratch, is really cool because you can actually make your own design. If you are a graphic designer, you can create your own logos, you can change the color of the widget, the fonts, it's really cool. While on the second one, you're kinda limited. You can only rely on the official widget design. And basically over here, you can only have two colors, the black one and the white one, when you are using the dark mode or the daylight mode, I would call it that way. The second thing is that the first method is quicker, refreshing the subscribers count. The concept of the widget is to have a real-time update, okay? So I'm going outside and I wanna make sure that every single time I unlock my phone, I get the accurate subscribers count right there. but it's all about a refresh rate, okay? So it keeps on scanning for the actual subscribers count based on the refresh rate. And the refresh rate on the application is kind of long. As you guys can see, this screenshot right here illustrates both of the widgets. On Widgerido, I've got 877 subscribers, while on the application one, I've got 876 subscribers. This is because someone just subbed to my channel and the application didn't update it yet. So it takes some time, but that's okay because this is just the 1.0 version and I believe that the developer is going to solve this thing by making the refresh rate even shorter on the next updates. That's it for today, guys. If you like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe to the channel, as it really helps me in reaching more people interested in this content. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.